Hi, this is Dr. B. Let's do the Lewis structure for CS2. On the periodic table, carbon's in group 4, sometimes called 14, so it has 4 valence electrons. Sulfur in group 6, or 16, it has 6. We have 2 sulfurs, so let's multiply that times 2. 4 plus 12, 16 valence electrons. Let's draw it. Carbon, the least electronegative, goes in the center, and then we'll put the sulfurs on either side here. Now we want to add our valence electrons. Remember, we've got 16 to work with. So we'll put 2 between the atoms, and then we'll put them on the outside. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. We've used those 16 up. Let's see if we have octets. 8 on that sulfur, 8 on that sulfur. Those have full outer shells. But in the middle, carbon only has 4. So we've got to fix that. We can take and move valence electrons between atoms and share them so that this sulfur has 8 now still. But the carbon has 6. We're almost there. Let's share this side here to be symmetrical. And now, again, we have 8 on that sulfur, but the carbon now has an octet. So it's stable and its octet is satisfied, and we've used only the valence electrons that we had available. So we have this structure here, and we can also write it as what is called a structural formula, and that's going to look like this right here. And with the structural formula, a line represents a pair of electrons. So we have 2 pair of electrons here, and we have these 2 lines here. That's the Lewis structure for CS2. This is Dr. B, and thank you for watching.